Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, and if you're new here, my name is Tanika. In today's video, I am going to be talking about the steps I took inside and outside to help clear my acne. I started experiencing breakouts from about 13 years old. I am 28 now, so it has been a very long time, and I finally feel like I have control of it. So if you're interested in hearing the steps I took, then just stay tuned. Plain and simple, what helped clear my skin was becoming educated on the acne topic, and I did this by doing the f.acne program. Now before you go, whoa, hold up, I didn't come here to sign up for no program. Just hear me out and listen to what I have to say. I come across a woman on Instagram named Nicola from The Unrefined. I don't know when, I don't know how, but I loved her healthy outlook on life. Nicola also suffers from acne, and after years of trial and error, she got fed up, decided to get together with some health professionals and create her own long-term management strategy and then share it with the rest of us. I am not sponsored by f.acne. This isn't a collab video. I genuinely enjoyed this program and learned so much from it. You can see it in my skin, and so I wanted to share this with you. I'll insert some clips and pictures of what my skin has looked like over the last 2 to 3 years. As you can see, lots of big breakouts on my chin and my cheeks. They were always really sore and big under the skin pimples. They hung around for a really long time and always left dark red pigmentation. And I'll just give you a close-up of what my skin looks like today. My skin isn't perfect, but it has definitely improved. I am not magically healed of acne. This definitely wasn't a one-step solution. It was a journey, and it's still going to be a journey for me. If you're acne prone, you're acne prone. I know it hurts to hear that, but that's the way it is. So it's about finding your acne why, finding your triggers, and learning how to manage them. The triggers for my acne are hormones, stress, and my gut health. It seems like a lot, and again, this is a journey to find your acne triggers, but that's what I loved about the program. It goes over a 5-week period, so it's not overwhelming, and there are a community of others doing the program with you. So you have that support from other people who truly understand the struggles and the insecurities that come from dealing with acne. So the topics that the program touch on are nutrition and acne with a dietitian, hormones with a naturopath, acne stress with a psychologist, conventional medicine with a GP, and acne and skincare treatments with a skin specialist. As I mentioned, one of the triggers for my acne are to do with hormones, and I'm sure a lot of women out there can relate to this. I started tracking my period on an app. First, I was using Clue, but I've recently changed over to Flow. And what I found was that a week before my period, I was having huge breakouts. So before, when I wasn't tracking my period, I'm just thinking, great, I've got pimples again. But now I know the reason why I've got these pimples. And in the program, you learn all about hormones and what they do to your body, and trust me, it's a lot. So having breakouts before my period is something that's going to happen to me, and I'm okay with that. The next trigger for me was stress, and this is a tough one because life these days is just so stressful. My job is a stressor for me, not because I don't enjoy it, but because of the industry. So I work in hospitality, and at peak times when it is hella busy, my stress levels, they rise. And then once the rush is over, they go back down again. And then an hour later, they're rising again. So all throughout the day, my stress levels are just going up and down. Then there's everyday general life stresses. Things that you may not even notice are causing you stress, like things on your to-do list. For me, planning a wedding is quite stressful. I'm also a bit of an empath, so I take on other people's emotions quite easily. This can actually be a big stress for me because I'm always worrying about how they're going to fix their problems or if I can help fix their problems. It comes from a kind place in my heart, but when I stop and think about it, I don't need to be putting so much stress and energy into worrying about other people's problems. I got my own to worry about. This is something that I'm working on, but saying all this, stress is just a part of life. So the program goes over different ways to help you deal with stress, and now I make de-stressing daily a priority for me. Once I figured out these situations and the things that really stressed me out, it became a lot easier for me to deal with them in a more calm way. Some things that I like to do in my downtime and things that de-stress me are watching Friends. This is such a comfort show to me. I can sit there and watch it. I can have it playing in the background and I instantly feel calm. I love putting a speaker in the bathroom and listening to music while I'm in the shower. Sometimes I even sit down and just have the hot water running over me. It's so calming and relaxing. Music is actually quite a good de-stressor for me, especially if I'm driving somewhere. I just crank the music and sing my little heart out. Quite embarrassing when I get caught, but hey, it makes me feel good. I found that doing yoga and stretching is a really nice way for me to calm down and release the inner stresses. I'm a very list-orientated person as well, so I have a to-do list every single day. If I don't have one done, it really stresses me out. My head feels quite overcrowded, so I need to get these things out of my head and onto paper. Even if it's just little daily tasks, it feels so much better when they're down on a piece of paper. I've also been doing a bit more journaling. So in the program, Nicola has what is called the AM pages. I did talk a little bit about this in my 2020 goals video, but essentially what you do in the mornings is you write down how you want to feel for the day. So you're setting the tone for the day. Then you write down what you're grateful for. So a bit of gratitude journaling. Next, you write down any worried thoughts. This was so helpful. I'm not really an anxious person, but writing down even the smallest worried thoughts and then writing down an action helped to get it out of my head and dealt with on the piece of paper. It really feels good for me to have the problem and the solution, or kind of a solution, written down, so I'm not going over it and over it in my head all day. And then lastly, you write down your top three priorities for the day. So doing this journaling has really helped me, and then at times where I feel like I've got a lot more emotions, I will just write it down in my diary as well. The next thing was a big one, and I truly think this was the main problem solver to my acne, and it is to do with my gut health. This is slightly touched on in the f.acne program, but Nicola did release a second program called Gut Skin Mind, and this was a game changer for me. This delves deeper into the gut, skin, mind axis, where scientifically there is a link between everything you are experiencing. So an unhealthy gut and or an unhealthy mind can equal unhealthy skin, and this was the case for me. This program was a little bit more challenging to me as it did contain a low FODMAP diet and a reintroductory phase. So essentially you're not eating foods that are going to inflame your gut, and then you slowly reintroduce them and see how your body reacts. As I said, it was challenging, but it really helped my gut health and therefore helped my skin. I've also had gut issues for years now, and I have seen a naturopath about it. She wasn't really my style and it was hella expensive. So doing the Gut Skin Mind program was about more than just my skin. Essentially, acne is a sign of inflammation in the body, and I needed to fix myself from the inside out. Changes in my diet have been very important. I really try to not eat a lot of refined sugars or carbohydrates. Don't get me wrong, I still eat these things, but I know how it's going to affect my body. Overall with these programs, it's about education. You don't have to do the f.acne program. You can go online and do your own research. But what I loved about the f.acne program is that Nicola herself has been through all of this, and she's done all the hard work, all the research, and put it together for you. Overall though, I have learned what my acne triggers are and how to manage them. I do still get breakouts, but now I can determine why, and I feel like I have more control over it than what I have in the past. I'll touch on skincare a little as well. I've always been a skincare fanatic, but I still had acne. So although skincare definitely helps, for me, the number one cure was taking a look at my gut health. Skincare is a very personal thing. What works for me may not work for you. So I suggest educating yourself on what products are going to work best for your skin and then go from there. I don't like talking really deep about skincare and the ingredients because I'm not an expert. I've done a bit of my own research and have now created my own little routine. So my morning routine starts with me washing my face with a gentle cleanser. At the moment, I'm using the Skinstitute Gentle Cleanser. Next, I go in with a vitamin C product. This really helps with the pigmentation left from my pimples. I then go in with a light moisturizer and an SPF. My nighttime routine starts off with me removing my makeup. I like to use my Bisou facial cleansing cloths. They are reusable makeup removing cloths. I then go ahead and wash my face with the same cleanser I used in the morning. If I am feeling a little bit more textured, I will go in with my Skinstitute glycolic scrub, or I'll use my Clarisonic. But I only do this 1 to 3 times a week, depending on how my skin is feeling, because I've learned over the years that gentle is best. Next, I use a liquid exfoliant 2 to 3 times a week. I've been using the Paula's Choice BHA 2% liquid exfoliant for years now. If you have a lot of texture to your skin or blackheads, this product will work wonders for you. Next, I'll do a bunch of different things. I've started introducing a retinol into my routine because, you know, I'm getting closer to my 30s. I also go in with a variety of serums or facial oils, and then I always finish off with a nice rich moisturizer. My skin isn't completely cleared of acne, but it has improved so much, and I am so happy with that. I remember when I was probably 14 or 15, and one of my aunties was up visiting, and she was like talking about how bad my skin was, and at that time, Proactive was really big, and she was talking about, I think you should really go on Proactive, rah, rah, rah. And I remember looking in the mirror and just crying. Like, it makes me cry now. Acne can really take a toll on you. It's painful physically and emotionally. And having dealt with it for so long, I was just getting absolutely fed up. I'm like, am I really going to enter my 30s with the same acne I had when I was a young teenager? Like, it just gets to that point where you are fed up. I am so grateful that I stumbled upon Nicola's Instagram and that she created this program, because it has really helped to educate me, and now I know my acne whys and how to deal with them. I know you probably wanted to hear that I had some sort of magic cream or easy solution that's a nice quick fix, but it's not. As I mentioned, this is a journey. It's about getting to know your body, know how your body reacts to things, and dealing with it from there. Even though I still experience breakouts, I am mentally more okay with it than what I was in the past. All right, well, that is all from me today. I hope you found this video helpful in one way or another. If you did enjoy it, please give it a thumbs up for me. If you are currently struggling with your acne, just know that you are not alone and there are answers. I will link all relevant information down in the description box below, but if you still have some questions, make sure you leave me a comment. I would love to have a chat with you guys about this. If you're new to my channel, please take a look around and consider subscribing. Otherwise, I hope you're all having a fabulous day, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.